This week in Indonesia, the famed Ijen volcano, known for producing blue lava through burning molten sulfur, was recently confirmed to be experiencing uplift, which may very well still be ongoing due to a possible magmatic intrusion. Meanwhile, in Iceland, the Bárðarbunga volcano produced its largest earthquake in nearly 7 months, which registered in as a magnitude 4.8 and was followed by numerous aftershocks. And, in what is this week's top story, the Trident volcano in Alaska had its alert level raised on the exact same day that a massive 6-mile-wide and more than 2,000-foot-deep caldera volcano known as Aniakchak also had its alert level raised. However, there is more. Adjacent to the Trident volcano, the Mount Magiak and Mount Martian volcanoes are also displaying unusual activity as they are both producing an elevated number of earthquakes. However, the quakes at those two volcanoes, at least in my opinion, appear to merely be secondary in nature to the main event, which is a likely magmatic intrusion that is ongoing underneath the Trident volcano. This magmatic intrusion has been ongoing since at least August 24, 2022. Over time, these quakes got shallower and shallower until on August 29, 2022, the likely intrusion reached a shallow depth, perhaps interacting with the area's hydrothermal system, causing quakes to suddenly branch out in a horizontal manner, and also occurring at one volcano to the northeast and two volcanoes to the southwest in what was a possible sill intrusion. Ever since then, earthquakes at Mount Katmai have decreased from their peak while the other three have remained high, although occurring in intermittent spikes of activity. Thus, when another earthquake spike occurred at Trident on February 22nd of 2023, its alert level was raised from green to yellow for the third time in the last 12 months. While it is unclear whether this latest activity will result in a volcanic eruption at any of these volcanoes, if one was to occur, it would most likely originate at Trident, probably at its southwest Trident cone as that last erupted in 1974. A similar scenario may have been ongoing at Aniakchak unnoticed for several months until a sudden spike in earthquakes caused its alert level to also be raised from green to yellow on February 22, 2023, which, in my opinion, possibly represents that dike propagation has begun at its shallow magma chamber. Although, Aniakchak has not had its alert level raised since it last erupted in 1931. Since four volcanoes in Alaska are at an alert level of yellow and four others in the state are also showing signs of unrest, I have placed them in my opinion based volcanic unrest scale to help portray the intensity of unrest at each volcano. In Indonesia, the famed Ijen volcano on the island of Java is famed for the sheer abundance of sulfur it produces, so much in fact and adjacent to such heat that the sulfur crystals melt into a liquid and parts of it ignite, creating what is referred to as blue lava. Because of this level of sulfur deposition, it should not come as a surprise that this volcano is still highly active. Ijen has been at a raised alert level of yellow since January 7, 2023, alongside a placed mandatory exclusion zone which currently goes out to 1,500 meters beyond the edge of its large crater rim, which holds its acidic crater lake. This acid lake has continued to increase in temperature in recent days, as in January it was measured at 46 Celsius, but as of February 19th was measured at 65.8 degrees Celsius. Additionally, from February 1st through February 18th, the central crater of Ijen was uplifted by 5 centimeters. This suggests that a shallow magmatic intrusion, in my opinion, might be ongoing, which could result in a phreatic or phreatomagmatic eruption with little or no warning. Thus, for now, the exclusion zone and yellow alert level should remain in place. On February 21st, a magnitude 4.8 earthquake struck at shallow depths underneath the Bárðarbunga volcano in Iceland. While this would go on to cause more than a dozen aftershocks, these luckily did not indicate anything truly unusual at the volcano. Bárðarbunga is at the intersection of the spreading of the North American and Eurasian plates, and the quake appeared to be tectonic in origin rather than volcanic. Six similar magnitude 4 events occurred at this volcano in 2022, and none of these resulted in a volcanic eruption. Here is a quick list of all of the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on February 25th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.